Hey, what's up, everybody? Gonna do a great rock reaction, man. This is Artist of the Month, John Paul Jones. And we are now in the latter portion of the month. So this is John Paul Jones in his post-Led Zeppelin years. That's what we're gonna be covering for the rest of the month. And I'm gonna start off with a concert reaction, man. Take in a lot of him in his post-Zeppelin years. And get a feel for the sound, how he jams, how he looks live. We're going to be checking out Crooked Vultures at Rockplast 2009. Before I get this going, I just want to give a shout out and a thanks to Bayou Maccabee. Thanks, Bayou. Bayou's got a note, man. I just saw your Jonesy Month video, and it made me laugh because my next reaction submission was actually going to be the John Paul Jones collaboration supergroup, Them Crooked Vultures, with Dave Grohl and Josh Homme. Josh Homme, guitarist and vocalist for Queen of the Stone Age, Dave Grohl, drummer for Nirvana. They released only one studio album, but I'm submitting to you the complete live show of Them Crooked Vultures at Rockplast 2009. I didn't know you were about to do a Jonesy Month on the Classic Rock channel, but being that this group is not a classic rock band, but a modern rock band with a classic rock icon as a member who also happens to be the subject of Jonesy Month, I will leave it up to you as to which channel on which you want to post it. Perfect timing, man. Much peace and love. Right on. Thank you, Bayou, and thanks for the consideration. That's very important in trying to kind of keep things balanced between the platforms and the consideration for especially those very, very old cats that I've got on my classic rock platform who have this very this is not classic rock, this is classic rock in the end. But I'm the gatekeeper, you see, you dig? So in the end, I will decide ultimately what is and what isn't and where what goes. So this is my verdict. I'm gonna put this on both platforms. Some don't migrate, so it's good for them to see it on either. So I think that's what it's going to be. Like, you know, Jonesy is a classic rock artist, and fusing it with modern rock and whatnot, it can go on either platform. But you know what? I don't think people will mind. You got to sometimes let a little bit of shit slide. You got to allow a little bit of overlapping, you know, because music in its sense is just fusion, you know. I like to keep the regiment between classic rock and other things separate, but sometimes there is overlapping. In this case, perfect example. I might change my mind after, but we'll see how it goes, man. Excuse me, I got a damn frog in my throat. I drank coffee first thing in the morning. I know I shouldn't do that, but I did. All right. I got my sugarcane rum, though. Let's do this. Them Crooked Vultures, 2009, live at Rockplast. Let's go all the way through. Let's get it. This is a 2-hour reaction and review, by the way, just so you know. I like it already. I've never seen him play slide before. Is that a regular slide guitar? It seems a little bit more strings on it. I wonder if Jonesy plays the sax. That would make him my favorite. Jonesy's got the same position on the stage as his Zeppelin days. Drumming and singing. Props to you. Great start. Oh, look at that shot. Great shot. Look at that. Ocean.
We're very excited to be with you. You're beautiful. This is called Dead End Friends.
Thank you.
to fire. Fresh balls of the spell powder. I know who you are. Night, open the door and climb in line. Call down the cross and do it again. Take for the dust of my dead and friend. Alone, that's just gone.
Listening to the bass riff. Great bass work. Dead End Friends. So then, Scumbag Blues.
Thank you very much.
I'm at the link here looking at the set list.
This is called Scumbag Blues.
It's good they got screenshots so I don't have to add mine. I love the shots of the crowd, man. I gotta know who these guys are. Who is this lad right here? He's got skills. And the guy singing lead, I've got a good. That was excellent. Gave him a little bass spotlight.
Sound, I can tell,
hold on.
I'd like to get this over with, actually. That's Mr. Dave
Grohl. Okay, there we go. Dave Grohl. Talented brother.
Audience, this is on guitar. This is Mr. Alan Johannes. Alan Johannes.
Let me know where Alan is from. What band? What he's done before?
Audience, that's John Paul Jones. I'm Joshua.
Okay.
I'm an alcoholic. And this is called Elephant.
Okay. Josh Homme. Queens of the Stone Age. Okay. We'll be right back. I remember Dave Grohl is one of Yoko Sono's favorite drummers, and he gave her a shout out when she was a guest on Ellen, I believe it is. These things are coming to me now. I can see why she likes him. He's got a lot of spirit in his delivery. Guys jam very, very well, man. Great live sound.
I'd like to play you a song that's not on a record. This is called Highway 1. Right on the road.
What instruments can Jonesy not play? That was an excellent jam. Standing room only, packed like sardines, man.
Thank you.
That's got a lot of trust, man. These guys are so lucky getting to see them live, man. Gunmen. almost like being in Rio.
Angry ants are crawling, makes you wanna scream.
Great jam, man. What's this one? Bandoliers. I've got a serious question for you guys after this. A Jimmy Page question.
You really blew that moment for me, sweetie. I know what the problem is.
Controlled wild man vibe, doesn't he? Dave Grohl. This guy Allen's got skills now.
Just to let you know.
performance with all those Panda lyrics. Mind Eraser, No Tracer.
How you guys doing?
Mind Eraser, No Chaser. I like their sudden starts. They're playing and then they just stop abruptly.
No, no, don't get all fucking scared. It's a love song. It's a good thing.
It's a ballad.
I said love song, bro. I'm excited about it.
Don't use
song.
The L word, man. Caligula.
Caligula.
Jonesy on the keys, working those foot pedals, making it look so easy. So Interlude with Ludes is next. Excellent. The crowd liked that too.
Thank you.
So that thing that Jonesy is playing here, it's a fusion guitar, I take it. He can switch from bass to electric.
Oh,
nothing like having a bunch of great musicians get together and do their thing, man. Nice. Legend.
John Paul Jones.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Facebook. And you know everybody there is having a good time with this.
On drums, Mr. Dave Grohl. I just wanted to get you clapping. Hi, darling. How you doing? You good? Oh, thank you very much. It's called The First Breath You Take After You Give Up. She's really into you, actually. Well, this song's dedicated to you, Fräulein. Damen. Meine kleine Schmutzfink. The geile Sau.
What the hell does that mean?
I was trying to do some shit. something to look up to. Troubles are made to stay, don't they? We'll be worse than it follows you home. It's all have none, hey, can I have some? Until I've had enough, yet I've had enough. Sun goes down. I'm having fun down things. Disappears in her gown. You find the top neighbor. Well, good shit, what for it's a good night talk. That ain't for my level. Feels so good together. Give it, give it your world.
Doesn't he have a resemblance to Michael Weatherly, the actor? They could be brothers. He used to be Tony DiNozzo on ICS. NCIS.
Hack your way through real life. It's almost entirely life. I know it hurts. It hurts to be young.
Controlled Wild Man. Frenzy now. They know this is the last number. this excellent thing. Great show. Great show. Great collab. Mixing of rock musicians, the generations. It produces something as awesome as this. Right on. That was excellent. A really great way to kick off post Led Zeppelin Jonesy month. He's in great form there, man. Smiling, singing, playing so many damn instruments. Really just a fantastic showing of what he can do, especially when he's paired with such excellent musicians. He's in really, really good company here, man. Fantastic. I enjoyed the whole thing all the way through from beginning to end. Bayou had this crazy asinine idea that if I don't want to go through the whole thing, I should stop after one of the numbers that featured Jonesy. At least I can actually see him play the keyboards. But, you know, there's no way. It's like, how would I put it? It's like taking a piss and stopping halfway. Sorry for my crude sailorness. But, yeah, man, it should not ever be done, right? You got to go all the way through. So, let's call this the end of the reaction phase. Come on back, man, and then let's hit up a review. Plus, I got a Jimmy Page question for you. All right, see you in a sec. Okay, y'all, here we are back again, man. Fantastic concert. These guys sound so good, and they're in their zone in front of a live audience, just jamming and extending those songs, man. Fantastic. Really, really good. Every single one of those musicians in the zone, and they damn very, very well together. Having fun, they're loose, and yeah, man, really, really excellent. I'm glad I watched the whole thing. So, two things. One, we're just going to focus on the band themselves, find out about their history and how they came about, whose idea it was, all of that sort of good stuff, some of the good stories behind the music. But first, I got a question. Gotta ask you guys a question. A Jimmy question. Jimmy Page question. Answer me this. I heard that Jimmy might have been a little bit pissed at the fact that he was not invited to play lead guitar for them Crooked Vultures. And I guess maybe he was expecting it, being that he is a colleague, probably almost a brother of John Paul Jones. So it's one of those things where it's expected. Maybe that's kind of like the impression that I'm getting, and that didn't happen. So let me know about that. One or two people mentioned that, and I was wondering, I was going, in my mind. I don't like to speculate too much, because sometimes it's just the wrong thing, you know? So I want to really, really make sure that I got my facts straight. So if you've got some background about that, some context, give it to me. Let me know. Give me a decent history on it. So that was the one thing. And I'm thinking about it. And someone was also suggesting that it's kind of like, what do you call it? Is it a cruel irony? Is that what it's called? I know, you know, some people, we throw the word karma around and all of that sort of thing. There's another saying. But anyway, the idea of Page and Plant not including Jones, not even letting him know what they were going to do in the No Quarter tour. And then full circle, you know, Jimmy is not included. So it's kind of like, you know, what goes around comes around, getting his just desserts, that sort of thing. I wonder if there might have been a little bit of that in play. I don't know. Who's to say? You can't say either way. But anyway, give me some background and give me your take on it, okay? I don't want to just speculate out of thin air. So, with that out of the way, let's focus on these guys, man. Find out how they came about. Them Crooked Vultures. Them Crooked Vultures is an alternative rock supergroup formed in LA in 2009 by Josh Holm of Queens of the Stone Age and Chaos. On lead vocals and guitar, John Paul Jones of Led Zeppelin on bass and keyboards, and Dave Grohl of Foo Fighters and Nirvana on drums and backing vocals. The group also includes guitarist Alan Johannes during live performances. Alan was awesome. He was just stellar. The band began recording in February of 2009 and performed its first gig in Chicago on August 9, 2009, followed by a European debut on August 19th. On October 1st, the group embarked on the worldwide Deserve the Future tour, with dates going into 2010. The band's first single, New Fang, was released in October 2009, followed by its self-titled debut album the following month, which debuted at number 12 on the Billboard 200. The group won the 2011 Grammy Award for Best Hard Rock Performance for New Fang, winning Grammys too. So, Beginnings and Them Crooked Vultures, from 2005 to 2009. Okay, a collaboration between Josh Holm, John Paul Jones, and Dave Grohl was first publicly mentioned by Grohl in a 2005 interview with Mojo, in which he declared, "The next project that I'm trying to initiate involves me on drums, Josh Holm on guitar, and John Paul Jones playing bass." In a 2019 post on his Facebook page, Jimmy Page suggested that he could have been part of the band as well, based on conversations he had with Grohl. Okay. There we are. Yeah, so, alright. It's very, very possible. It's like a tease. It's like a waving a carrot in front of a horse's nose. Now, maybe not to that extreme. I don't know. Maybe it was just one conversation of passing over a beer or something like that, and then it was forgotten about later on. And, oh, yeah, shit. We should have included Jimmy, something like that. Of the nascent project, Holmes' wife, Brody Dowell, commented in July 2009 that, "I'm not at liberty to talk about it, but I think the project is pretty amazing. It just beats and sounds like you've never heard before." After finding that the name Caligula was already taken, the members arbitrarily chose Them Crooked Vultures as a name with no significance. Really? How could you just pull that shit out of the air? Right? There's gotta be something, man. There's gotta be a little bit more to it. I just can't be sitting there having a drink saying to myself, "Yeah, let's call our shit Them Crooked Vultures," without any kind of inspired thought. No, there's more to that. Let me know. British music magazine NME reported in July 2009 that the trio had began recording in LA. Okay, so hiatus and possible second album from 2010 to the present. Yeah, it's been that long, hasn't it? Well, they're busy guys, yeah. Grohl said in an interview that they are working on a second album that will be more powerful than the first one. John Paul Jones also stated in an interview while touring in New Zealand that they will be recording a new album. When asked about the futures of Grohl and Holmes' band, Joslin, December 2012, when asked about the band's future, Dave Grohl stated, "We talked about it. I know that someday we'll get back together and do stuff because we love playing with each other." Grohl once again mentioned a possible reunion in an interview with Zane Lowe on Apple Music's Beats 1 radio station in June 2017. In an interview with The Guardian in August of 2019, Grohl stated, "It's still hard to accept that I got to play in a band with John Paul Jones. Technically, we're still a band. We practice once every decade, and we're coming up on another decade. I don't have any official news, but there's always something cooking." In a further interview with NME. Grohl elaborated. We've talked. We've got together. I never say never. If you want me to be your drummer, we either have to be best fucking friends, or you have to be better than Josh Homme and John Paul Jones. If those guys call and say that it's time to go, then I'm gonna go, because that's the band. That's the band that I want to be the drummer of forever. Josh and I talk about it all the time. I know that John would love to as well. It's also like herding cats, so we'll see. That's what my mom used to say. So we'll see. Okay, and said that they will get their front man back eventually. Okay, I see. Okay. Yeah, sorry for my choppy reading. All kinds of commas and shit in different places. Alright, hey. So that's the history of them Crooked Vultures. So I imagine that a lot of you fans are just anxiously awaiting their second album, which could drop any time, you know, either this year or next year or whatever it is. But I can see them getting together. I mean, they really jam very well. And this is live. I imagine that their studio sound is probably even more polished and everything like that. So yeah, man, these guys really got it going on. They've got an excellent, excellent sound. How cool was Jonesy on that bass, man? Just killing it. So, let me just see what I got going on before I bounce. So I'll continue with Jonesy's Artist of the Month, his post-Zeppelin stuff. And my goal, what I'm visualizing, is to check out his solo albums, trying to get a feel for his sound and what he was looking to do and things like that. Maybe there's, I don't know, interviews or written material surrounding his thought processes and creating his solo works, and go from there. So if you've got anything like that, send it my way. Alright, man. Jeffrey, Susan, Pete, Jennifer, I've got reactions loaded for you guys. So that is my reaction to this really, really excellent concert. Fantastic. Bayou, thank you very much. And yes, of course, I'm going to do the whole damn concert, man. Thanks for the consideration. But don't come at me like with, yo, if you don't want to do the whole thing, just stop here. No, man, you got to do the whole damn thing. All right. So with that said, I'm going to bounce, y'all. Yeah, that's pretty much all I've got going on for this week. And going to finish off Jonesy Month real strong, packing as much in as possible. My goal, supposedly you're not supposed to share what your goals are, because somehow, I don't know, things get in the way and prevent it from happening, so you shouldn't actually be sharing your goals. But my goal, and I'll share it with you, man, send me some positive vibes. Don't block me mentally and spiritually. My goal is to try and see if I can beat the Who's record where it comes to reactions. I believe it was 16 for the Who. So I want to try and at least match it or beat it. It's a tall feat, because I think, what is it now? This is the seventh one. So wish me luck. We'll see how that goes. But that's my goal, man. Before I really start getting busy with work in the next week or so, I want to try and see if I can get as many reactions out for Jonesy as possible. Anyways, thanks for joining me. Bayou, thanks again for the recommendation. Peace out, guys. Have a good one. And I'll see you in a day or so with my next Jonesy reaction. Peace.